All right, I hope the retailers and the mobile service operators are listening in here. Also, Dr. Senthilvelan, it's not just this. Verification of the address is normally given to an outsourced agency, and that takes place only after the SIM card is issued, after the SIM card is sold, and that possibly after a threat call or some obnoxious SMS is sent. So the damage is already done.
Yeah, again, the rules are strict. Normally, after the verification process is complete, then the things are activated. That is one particular gray area which the service providers also need to address. And it takes time for the verification because the number of cards being issued is phenomenal. It's mind-boggling figures, and they don't have enough facilities to conduct a check of the ID proof. So that needs to be addressed, and they need to enforce it on a more strict basis.
All right. Dr. Senthil, would you also advise the public to be more careful, more cautious about giving out photocopies of their ID proof to outsiders, because it can be easily misused and used to get a SIM card and later to commit crimes, as we've seen?
Yeah, definitely. Utilizing, probably issuing your ID card or even your photograph is a risk these days because of the number of offenses in which the forged mobile phones are being used, SIM cards are being used. So they need to be more careful, and this problem wouldn't arise if the retailers, again I would repeat it, the retailers, if they don't issue the SIM cards, if the photo and identity does not tally with the person who comes and procures the card. So if this is enforced in toto, it should not be a problem. I think it's the responsibility of the retailers and the service providers to ensure it, and in case there's any violation, the service provider should cancel the license, whatever agreement which he has with the retailer. And in case it's been utilized for an offense, and the retailer is liable to be punished for abetting the offense.
All right, abetment as serious an offense as actually the actual commission of the offense. Let's also cut across to our other experts now. We've got Mr. Kumar and Mr. Rajan. Mr. Rajan, of course, the General Secretary of the Consumers Association of India. Thank you very much, Mr. Rajan, for joining us. Also, Mr. Kumar, who's a mobile phone user. Mr. Rajan, to you first. Like, you know, mobile, do you believe that photocopying centers in the city should also be brought under the scanner, just like internet parlors?
Well, I personally experienced it that, you know, when you go to an internet center and, you know, ask them to take a print, and this happened to me personally. That person asked me to give my ID. I said, look, you know, why do you need an ID? He said, no, I mean, for you to take a print, you know, we need to know who you are, because we don't know what you are printing out. And there's a rule. The police are having a rule in place whereby they are insisting that anybody entering into an internet center and wanting a print, he should be, you know, verified. Now, I don't know, I don't think that is applicable for photocopying, but that's applicable for taking prints. That is, if my computer is in a blink, I go to an internet browser and take a print, then they insist on that.
Alright, that's interesting. So I really hope people comply, because people normally make a fuss even when it comes to security, even being frisked. Mr. Kumar, if I can bring you in here, when you go, let's for an average citizen, when we go to a photocopying center, and we ask for photocopies, let's say of a passport or a driving license, it's usually out of sight. The person goes inside, takes your document and comes out. You don't know how many extra copies he's made, and whether those extra copies are going to be siphoned off later for some illegal use, right? So we need to be careful as consumers.
It is very easy. Sanjay, it is very easy. Today's photocopy machine is so highly advanced, they can keep as many copies as possible in the memory also. So we got to be very careful that our papers are not misused or not fabricated. It is possible.
All right. What would you do when you go to a photocopying shop, Mr. Kumar? Would you insist on going inside there? Because again, at one level, it just depends on the layout and of the shop.
No, as an average customer, Sanjay, it is rather impossible to insist on whatever I want to do. But the thing is, as you rightly said, the police should bring in the scanner, all the photocopy, not only the photocopying centers, but also the retailers. See, they are following a perfect system as far as the passport issuance is concerned. What I would suggest is, this misuse of SIM card is possible mostly in postpaid and prepaid connection only, not on postpaid. So all the prepaid connection should be scanned randomly by the concerned area police station. DG sir is also on the show. I think he'll take this point. This could check the misuse of the SIM card at least to a bigger extent, sir.
All right, Mr. Kumar, also as a consumer, as an end user, some of the precautions that we can take. For instance, I know of people who every time they give out a photocopy, sometimes you go and even use, forget your credit card, even if you use your debit card in jewelry stores, for instance, in Tinagar, they ask you to give a copy of your proof of identity or address. What if, you know, that card is not valid or there's some, you know, fraud there? But when you give the card, when you give, when you give a photocopy of your proof of identity or address, perhaps it would be a good idea to actually write the purpose for which it's given, so that that person cannot, even if he photocopies it in turn, he will not be able to misuse it. Let's say you say for jewelry purchase, if you write against that photocopy, that would be probably a foolproof way of dealing with this.
Kumar? Yes, definitely, because you should know to whom you are giving. There is every possibility of misusing whatever documents you are giving, whatever photocopy you are giving. It is very simple. See, these are the days when the land grabbing is possible even with the fake documents. Why not with ration card and why not with driving license? Everybody, as a average customer, they got to be very alert. They should know the person personally. They should know whether it is being used properly. And they should also find out whether it is possible to be misused.
All right, Mr. Rajan, so, as a consumer activist,
to be very alert.
Right. Mr. Rajan, as a consumer activist now, when you sell your car, a two-wheeler or a four-wheeler, then of course you transfer it to somebody else's name. In the RC book, there's an endorsement made. Again, you record the time and the date of sale in your delivery note. What about recycled numbers of mobile phones?
You see, as far as mobile phones are concerned, I think there has got to be far stricter control exercised by the service provider. I would, in fact, put a greater responsibility on the service provider than what the police commissioner has said, because I think it's important for the service provider to conduct what is called a surprise checks. You know, in the good old days, we used to have decoy customers being sent by the companies into retail outlets to find out exactly how people are behaving, how the retailer is selling or underselling or overselling or misleading or making some wrong kind of commitments and so on. So I think it's not something easy, but I'm sure a system can be put in place, provided the service providers are made, let's say, 75% of the responsibility is theirs and only 25% responsibility is the retailer. I wouldn't go with this equal balancing of the responsibilities. I think service providers, in their anxiety to get numbers, in their anxiety to keep their market shares, they are going extra aggressive, if you ask me. And I think this is where they have got to balance out the cost of safety vis-a-vis the cost of getting more sales. Ultimately, it's they who are going to be in trouble, because if somebody is going to be using the SIM card of a particular service provider, I mean, that particular service provider gets a bad name tomorrow because it gets being connected with a nefarious kind of an activity.